தொடங்கல். So with the geography main session, what I'm trying to do is I will be discussing previous year questions. Okay, we have already covered all these areas for our prelims exam. So I'll be discussing specific areas where you can expect questions, and these areas are selected on two bases: either the previous year question from GS1 paper or the previous year question from the geography optional paper. Now, if you, I'll show the why I chose the second part. I'll show you one example. 2013. Fifth question. Okay, this particular part of the question were asked from or asked for the geography optional part. So this question was actually lifted from the previous year geography optional question papers. Like, they are not the recent years, rather than 1995 or maybe 2002, like that. Okay, so I have prepared an area from which, can you say this question was asked from which part of the syllabus? Third one. Not resources, you are having, like, within the third part itself, we are having another second part. Industries. So the third part includes resources and industries. You can expect questions from industries like this, you know, the either the iron and steel industry or cotton textile or sugar mill. And the, among the previous year questions, we are having like cement based industries or agro industries. So we will prepare on those topics as well as the answers for these topics also. If these questions repeat, you should have sufficient point with you to address this question. Same manner, we'll prepare probable questions from the selected topics also. Likewise, I have done the same thing, segregation work for the resource part as well as the physical geography part. Okay, so the main purpose is the answers for the previous question as well as probable question from related topics. Clear? Fine. So first of all, we'll see some of the questions based on the syllabus. The first part of the syllabus, words, physical geography. So let's see some of the questions that has been asked from that part of the syllabus. The air mass question of 2016. Discuss the concept of air mass and explain its macro climatic changes. Okay. Again, the same topic we would have studied for the prelims. We won't be expecting a question from that topic for the GS1 paper, right? But if we see the optional papers from climatology, there has been question from air mass based on its classification, origin, and only the second part is not there in the optional papers. All the other part were there in the lifted from the optional geography paper. Again, another from the previous the physical geography part. 2015 ocean current question. Explain the factors responsible for the origin of ocean currents. How do they influence regional climate, fishing and navigation? So on similar lines, we can expect another question based on ocean tides. Okay. Then behavior of Indian monsoon. This Indian monsoon we will be discussing in today's class. Okay, see that question. How far do you agree that the behavior of Indian monsoon has been changing due to humanizing landscapes? Discuss. Then again, the same logic, if you look at the optional paper, we are having like so many previous questions or model questions based on this particular part of the related with Indian monsoon, based on the origin, mechanism, or the characteristics of Indian monsoon. Then 2014. There has been lots of questions from 2014 onwards, like first question, second, third, as well as fourth. The areas are one, El Nino, then the second one, fault mountains and earthquake and volcanoes. Should we study geomorphology for GS1 paper? Yes, you can expect such kind of questions, either based on Earth's interior or on the rocks or like the fault mountains or the earthquake, volcanoes, all those things. Fine. Then third question, as well as like fourth question, tropical cyclones. Again, tropical cyclones is another favorite area of UPSC. I hope you already know that, right? We will be discussing Indian monsoon as well as tropical monsoon. Sorry, Indian monsoon as well as tropical cyclones in today's class. Then again, from 2013, first question, continental drift. Again, this question again was asked in the optional paper, again lifted from the GS and the geography optional question papers. Then the second part of the first question, tropical cyclones. Then heat islands, temperature inversion. Then 2013, third question. Major hot deserts in northern hemisphere are located between 20 to 30 degree north latitude and on the western side of the continent. Climatology. You already know the answer, right? The same topic we study for the prelims, you should be able to write within, you know, 200 words explaining this particular concept. What all points you have to bring up here, just briefly? Cold currents. Yeah. Easterly, west, trade winds, then subsidence, things like that. Fine. Fourth question. Bring out the causes for more frequent occurrence of landslides in Himalayas than in the Western Ghats. Again, landslides is another favorite area which we should prepare on. In the 2016 also, we are having question based on landslides. See the second question, 2016 second question. Himalayas are highly prone to landslides. Discuss the causes and suggest suitable measures of mitigation. So the overall logic with which we are preparing geography mains, we will be selecting certain static areas, you know, and we will be discussing, you know, you should have content within you, as in a point wise manner. You should be having certain content so that you can bring up those content for the answer. Okay, fine. Then read the second part of the syllabus. Distribution of key natural resources across the world. Then factors responsible for the location of primary, secondary and tertiary industries. So if you are studying about a particular industry, you should understand that why it is located or distributed in a certain manner. What are the factors necessary for that? Understood. And from the industries part, you can see the questions like 2014, 7th as well as 8th question. Seventh question is not there in the optional paper. Okay, it was completely new question. But the eighth question again was in the optional paper. Account for the change in spatial pattern of iron and steel industry in the world. Similar manner, the 2013 fifth question. I think that you already saw, right? 2013 fifth question. Sugar mills as well as cotton textile industries. So if you see the overall questions, the questions from industries part is less, but we cannot rule out a chance that they won't be asking from the industries part, right? So we should prepare on selected around some seven selected topics are there in industries part. Each industries which has been already asked, plus some of the already things they have asked for the geography optional paper. Clear? Then questions from the resource part. 2016 third question. Land and water resources. Again, 2015, third question. India is well endowed with freshwater resources. Critically examine why it still suffers from water scarcity. Again, you can say both questions are from related areas, right? Both from water resources. Then 2015. Sixth as well as seventh question. What are the economic significance of discovery of oil, Arctic Sea and its possible environmental consequences? Is that a conventional question or a current affair question? Current affair. So from the resource part, two things you should take care. We will be preparing on static areas, plus you should have an idea about any kind of current affair happening related with resource management. Can you name any current affair? For example, like think about shale oil or gas resources. We have been finding them, or their resource has been there in India. Okay, so they can ask questions based on that topic. Okay, so on resource part, our strategy is current affairs plus the conventional static part. Then 2015 seventh question, not entirely related with resource part, since but this question was asked from the GS1 paper. You can say that it's related with the resource part. Ecological carrying capacity. Then 2014, 9th as well as 10th question. Critically evaluate the various resources of the oceans, which can be harnessed to meet the resource crisis in the world. Now, is that a current affair or a conventional question? It's a general question from the static area, right? If you had prepared the resources in the oceans, we'd be able to answer it if you have certain selected points, right? Again, 10th question, 2014, 10th question. More of kind of an IR kind of question, right? but still it's asked in GS1. Again, another current affair based question. Then 2013, 6th question as well as 7th question. One related with the fossil fuels and other related with shale oil and gas. So, our strategy on resources part of the syllabus, static, certain selected static areas plus current affair. This current affair classes I will be taking after the entire conventional topics are over, we will be distributing videos based on the current affair topics related with geography. Okay. Now, the third part of the syllabus, geophysical phenomena, earthquake, tsunami, volcanic activity, cyclone, and it says etc. So, that you can expect questions based on say cloudburst. The previous year for the GS3 paper, the disaster management, they asked question related with cloudburst. So, you should prepare on the cloudburst from the perspective of GS1. It's again a disaster or geophysical phenomena, right? Again, plus heat waves. So, we'll be preparing on the terms given here, earthquake, tsunami, volcano, cyclones. Apart from that, we'll be also preparing on another expected geophysical phenomena. Clear? Let's see some of the questions from that part. Can say 2016, second question. Landslides is from the third part of the syllabus, right? Likewise, the 2014 second question, earthquake, volcanoes, fold mountains, 2014 fourth question, again 2013 first question B part and 2013 fourth question A part, not exactly related with the geophysical phenomena, but more related with the geophysical phenomena as well as the physical geography part. So, more questions are coming from physical geography. Then we have to prepare on industries as well as resources. On an average, from resources part, we are having at least two questions. If you see the entire question from resource part, on an average, we are having two questions. Okay. Any doubts? Fine.